richest 1% owns 82% of the world's wealth. Billionaires became 54% richer during the pandemic crisis. Global billionaire total wealth has increased more over the past 17 months of the pandemic than it did over the entire 15 years prior to the pandemic. There is something very wrong with this picture. Welcome to Pure Element 5. My name's Suzanne, and today's epiphany came from realizing that the current narrative is collapsing in the face of global crisis. And when narratives collapse, revolutions happen. New shoots of hope arise and new stories are created. A new earth is emerging. It's in our hands to reimagine our new story based on love and life. Billionaires have reaped a massive windfall at a time when millions have lost their lives and their livelihoods. The pandemic has supercharged existing global inequalities, with the wealthy profiteering from boarding up Main Street economies around the world. The cult of consumerism, accumulation, and excess is devastating the planet. Fundamentalism and authoritarianism are on the rise across the globe, and everyday freedoms are fast becoming a dream of the past, all for the sake of profit, power, and privilege. By the end of this video, you'll learn about disaster capitalism. The richest 1% own 82% of the world's wealth. While we were locked down in our homes, global total billionaire wealth rose more over those 17 months than the entire 15 years prior. There is something very wrong with this picture. Millions of people are trapped in their homes and therefore forced to use the digital world as their primary source of contact, both for basic services and social interaction. Whether it comes in the form of advertising revenue or the purchase of real goods, companies like Amazon, Apple, Google, Twitter, Facebook, and Microsoft, and others have massively increased their fortunes during the pandemic. They have quickly converted their quite literally captive audience into billions of dollars. At the most chaotic juncture in Iraq's civil war, a new law was unveiled that would allow Shell and BP to claim the country's vast oil reserves. Immediately following September 11, the Bush administration quietly outsourced the running of the war on terror to Halliburton and Blackwater. After a tsunami wiped out the coast of Southeast Asia, the pristine beaches were auctioned off to tourist resorts. New Orleans residents, scattered from Hurricane Katrina, discovered that their public housing, hospitals, and schools would never be reopened. These events, and many more, are examples of the shock doctrine, using the public's disorientation following mass collective trauma, wars, terrorist attacks, or natural disasters to achieve control by imposing economic shock therapy. A combination of austerity, privatization, and deregulation has destroyed the basic infrastructure in most countries. Corporations, freed from all regulations and responsibilities, are recklessly destroying communities, the environment, and scarring the planet for the most exploitable labor and that last drop of oil with ever more invasive and extractive technology. It's easy for even the most indoctrinated people to see that the world is being run by a handful of megalomaniacs and plutocrats. The underlying narratives pumped out through mainstream media that they own have created the fertile conditions and space for the rise of such totalitarianism. You may wonder what happened to the story of development, well-being, and progress for all. Here's the thing, the truth is that the world fell prey to the dangers of a single storyline.
If you thought this was pure engagement, please give us a thumbs up. And if you thought it was pure poo, feel free to give us a thumbs down. It helps us create the content you want to see. The links are down below if you want to catch us on other mediums, along with a link to our website so you can download our free ebook. Until we meet again, the essence of who you truly are is pure love. Go out and connect with someone and show them the love.